Can you see that? When's it ever gonna warm up? It's frozen again. It's 22 degrees. And it's, I don't know, it's whether that's snow or a sleet. It's it's more like a pellet. But it's awful lot like snow. Maybe it's a mix. I think it's a good day to make brats. That's what I'm gonna do. Check it out. Now look at it. It's really coming down. Bill Gowdy checking in. When's the weather ever gonna straighten out? I'm ready for spring. Rabbit season's closed in Illinois now. Closed on the 15th. Can hunt rabbits in Iowa until the end of the month. A couple more weeks. The snow will help. I don't know how long it's supposed to last. You know, I heard it was going to warm up today. we were going to have a little bit of chance of rain, but it's only 22 degrees. I'm going to make some brats, and rather than try to do it over in the fish cleaning station, yeah, I know it's cramped quarters in here, but I'm going to try to make them in here. I already got it warm in here. I got, you know, everything I need right in here. I just don't have the space. But rather than trying to heat that and out there with all the cold, let's give it a try, shall we? That is 5 pounds of ground deer and 20% pork. I'm using the Bratwurst Backwoods LEM, and I'm going to use the LEM casings, natural hog casings. Now I've already mixed this all up, and I put that in this, and I did that last night, so it's been sitting and marinating, and now I'm going to put it in the stuffer and make some brats. The quarters are cramped, let me tell you, but I think this is going to work. I can put my deer burger in here, and I can put it in the stuffer. I had to use it on the table because I don't have enough clearance. This top screw will run into the cabinets, and I can't turn the handle all the way around on that countertop. There's just not enough room, not enough clearance. This is tight, so I'm trying to get a long shot, but there's just not enough clearance between here and there. So yeah, I'm gonna make do with it on the table over here is my plan. So things are kind of in disarray. What do you think, Harry? You think this is gonna work? Harry doesn't say much, but he definitely approves. So I got everything all washed out and everything, so it's all ready to go. My table has got a little bit of a wobble, so that's kind of got me concerned. But you know, it's just got one leg on it. I hope it holds up. When you're stuffing the bratwurst and you're using the natural casings, they're packed in salt. So you have to rinse them off and then soak them for them to become pliable and hold the brats. Now when you're making the snack sticks, He's come with an edible casing, and you can peel that casing off too. You don't have to keep it on there, but you don't have to pre-soak these. You just use them like they are. So there's two different types of casings. There's the finished product. Looking good. We got a little bit more left in there. There's 5 pounds of bratwurst, deer bratwurst, and now I'm on to 5 pounds of the snack sticks. Again, this is, I seasoned this last night, and I'm ready to press it into the, I'm ready to stuff it. I am ready to stuff that. I use a smaller tube. I use a 17 millimeter. Let's see, where are they? I'm using the edible casings and by Lamb, and these are the 17 millimeter snack sticks. I like the smaller snack sticks. Now I have to cook these. I will put these in the smoker. So the trick is not to overstuff these by putting too much pressure on them, but yeah, you don't want them understuffed either. So it takes a little bit of a feel. The right amount of pressure, and you can hold it. You can hold it back, but if you hold it back too long and overstuff them, then the casings will blow a hole in them. And that's not good. There's the finished product. 5 pounds of snack sticks. Now I'll put them in the smoker. And I'll set that smoker for about 180 degrees, and then I'll put the probe in here, and I'll get that to 160 degree internal temperature. It's got pork in it, and I'll just start pouring the smoke to it right away. It doesn't take maybe a couple hours at the most to get those done, and then I like to put them in right after they hit the 160. I take them out of the smoker and put them in an ice bath, ice water, and wash them down. Man, those are good. I'm in my camper, and I got the probe in the snack sticks, and I can monitor the smoker and the temperature, the internal temperature of those snack sticks as it progresses. That's a real nice setup. I got this thermometer, the Therm Pro from Keith, the Bobcat guy. His link will be down below. I'll tell you what, I just use the heck out of this. It sure comes in handy, especially with that smoker. I don't know if you can see in there. The lighting's not real good, but look at the goodness. Oh, yeah.
at the goodness. Bill Gatti out. Thanks for watching. Bill Gatti out.